Hello everyone, welcome to a new session. Today we'll take up lesson 63. The title of the story is She Was Not Amused. 大家好，今天我们学习第63课，课文的标题是 She Was Not Amused. 她并不觉得好笑。Well, the story is about a man who was famous for his sense of humor among his friends.课文呢讲的是有一个人在他的朋友中以幽默感而著名。Okay, let's first take a look at the keywords and expressions. Jeremy Hampden, a large circle of friends, admire, sense of humor, Jenny, wedding reception.Sort, laugh at. Okay, as usual, I'm going to give you four questions on the text to help you grasp the story. 好，下面我们一起来看一看就课文提的问题。Question number one. What do Jeremy's friends admire him for? Jeremy 的朋友们钦佩他什么? Question number two. What was Jeremy asked to do by one of his friends recently? 最近 Jeremy 的一位朋友请他做什么? Question number three. How did the speech go? 演说词怎么样? Question number four.Why hadn't Jenny enjoyed the speech? Jenny 为什么不喜欢演说词?
Jeremy Hampden has a large circle of friends and is very popular at parties. Everybody admires him for his great sense of humor. Everybody, that is, except his 6-year-old daughter, Jenny. Recently,One of Jeremy's closest friends asked him to make a speech at a wedding reception. This is the sort of thing that Jeremy loves. He prepared the speech carefully and went to the wedding with Jenny. He had included a large number of funny stories in the speech, and of course, it was a great success. As soon as he had finished,Jenny told him she wanted to go home. Jeremy was a little disappointed by this, but he did as his daughter asked. On the way home, he asked Jenny if she had enjoyed the speech. To his surprise, she said she hadn't. Jeremy asked her why this was so.And she told him that she did not like to see so many people laughing at him.
How do you like the story? Have you enjoyed it? Well, actually, I find myself amused. Okay, now we are going to answer the questions. What do Jeremy's friends admire him for? Jeremy 的朋友们钦佩他什么?They admire him for his great sense of humor. 他们钦佩他那绝妙的幽默感。What was Jeremy asked to do by one of his friends recently? 最近 ,Jeremy 的一位朋友请他去做什么? He was asked to make a speech at a wedding reception, the sort of thing that Jeremy loves.他的朋友请他在婚礼上做一个祝词，这是 Jeremy 喜欢做的那一类事情。How did the speech go? 这祝词怎么样呢? Well, it was a great success because he had included in it a large number of funny stories. 祝词非常成功。因为他在里边加了许多滑稽的故事。Why hadn't Jenny enjoyed the speech. Jenny 为什么不喜欢助词 Because she did not like to see many people laughing at her father. 因为她不喜欢看很多人在嘲笑她的父亲。Okay, that's it for the questions and answers. Now, let's move on to the language points. 接下来我们看看本科的语言点。Jeremy Hampton has a large circle of friends and is very popular at parties. Jeremy Hampton 交际非常广，是各种聚会上深受大家欢迎的人。Circle 在这里是圈 ，circle of friends 朋友圈子。Political circles 意思是政界。Artistic circles 是艺术圈子。Financial circles 是金融界。Academic circles。学术界。Everybody admires him for his great sense of humor. Everybody, that is, except his 6-year-old daughter, Jenny.
每个人都钦佩他绝妙的幽默感。每个人是说除了他那6岁的女儿 Jenny 以外的每个人。这个句子中破折号后面的成分呢是对前面所做的补充说明。
That is, 是也就是说的意思，在这里呢做插入语。我们大家看一下这个介词 for, admire somebody for something. He was admired for his courage to speak out the truth.
人人都钦佩他，因为他有勇气说出真相。我们再来看看 for 的这种用法。
They criticized him for his rude manners.
大家都批评他，因为他的态度很粗暴。
Sense of humor
意思是幽默感。我们再来看看类似的词组。
Sense of shame,
羞耻感。
Sense of honor,
荣誉感。
Sense of duty,
责任感。
Sense of balance,
平衡感。
Sense of bearing,
方向感。好，我们再看下一个原点。
This is the sort of thing that Jeremy loves.
这是 Jeremy 喜欢的那一类事情。
The sort of thing 是指那一类的事情。
我们下面再来看看和 sort 有关的几个说法。
People of every sort and kind
意思是各种各样的人。
And that sort of thing
这个短语经常放在罗列事情的句子的后面，它的意思呢是以及诸如此类的事情等等。
He is not my sort.
这是口语中的一句话，意思是他不是我喜欢的那种人。
Nothing of the sort.
这也是口语中常用的话，意思是根本没有那样的事情。
Everything's been sorted out.
这句话的意思是一切都解决了。
Sort out
是一个词组，意思是解决事情。
Jeremy was a little disappointed by this, but he did as his daughter asked.
Jeremy 对此感到有些失望，但他还是照着女儿的要求做了。代词 this 指代的是前面提到的，也就是他的女儿想回家。
As 在这里呢是连词，表示以什么的方式。She told him,that she did not like to see so many people laughing at him.
她告诉他 他不愿意看到这么多的人嘲笑他。在这个句子中 ，laughing at him 是现在分词短语。那么这里，请大家要注意的是，跟感觉有关的动词后面加宾语，再加现在分词短语，这么一个结构。这里呢，就是 see so many people laughing at him。我们再来看几个例子。The other day, I saw him chatting with a group of people at Starbucks. 有一天，我看见他和一群人在星巴克咖啡馆聊天。在这里呢是 saw him chatting. Did you hear someone crying out there in the garden last night? 昨天晚上，你有没有听到有人在花园里哭泣？这里呢是 hear someone crying. Hear 是跟听觉有关的一个动词。I can feel my heart beating fast. 我能感觉到我的心脏跳得很快。这里是 feel my heart beating. Feel 感觉。语言点就讲到这儿，接下来我们看看本课的关键句型。在这一课中出现了比较多的间接引语，我们一起来看一下。As soon as he had finished, Jenny told him she wanted to go home. Jenny told him she wanted to go home 是间接引语。那么把它变成直接引语呢，就是 I want to go home, she said.On the way home, he asked Jenny if she had enjoyed the speech. To his surprise, she said she hadn't. Jeremy asked her why this was so, and she told him that she did not like to see so many people laughing at him.
我们来看看这一段中的间接引语。首先是 He asked Jenny if she had enjoyed the speech.
把它改成直接引语呢，就是 Have you enjoyed the speech? She said she hadn't. 改成直接引语就是 No, I haven't. 在下面 Jeremy asked her why this was so. 那么改成直接引语就是 Why is it so?She told him that she did not like to see so many people laughing at him.
改成直接引语就是 I don't like to see so many people laughing at you.
下面我们看看把祈使句的直接引语变为间接引语的情况。
Open the door for me, please, she said.
把这句话改成间接引语就是
She asked me to open the door for her. Don't make so much noise, she said to her children.
改为间接引语。
She told her children not to make so much noise.
那么这两个例子我们可以看出，把祈使句的直接引语改为间接引语的时候，要把 say 改成 ask 或者是 tell， 也就是变成Ask somebody to do something, 或者是 tell somebody to do something.
Stay to lunch, he insisted.
改为间接引语就是
He insisted that we should stay to lunch. Should
可以省略。
Come with me, he suggested.
改为间接引语
He suggested...that I should go with him.
Should 也可以省略。从这两个例子中我们可以看到，如果在直接引语的句子中动词是 insist 或者是 suggest 变为间接引语的时候呢，要跟 that 从句，后面的动词呢要用 should 加动词原形，或者去掉 should 用动词原形。好，最后我们再回到课文的内容上来。
Jenny was not amused by her father's sense of humor because she did not like to see so many people
laughing at her own father. In other words, she felt embarrassed for her father. She thought that he was making a fool of himself to please the other people.
换句话说 ,Jenny 为她的父亲感到有些尴尬,因为她觉得她的父亲呢是把自己变成小丑来取悦别人。
Well, it seems that young children cannot appreciate adults' ways of amusing themselves.
看来小孩子还是不能够理解大人们取悦的方式。
Okay, that's it for today's session. See you next time.